important concepts associated with the Declaration section. Firstly, it is an optional section. It is used to declare variables that will be used in a program. A variable is an object that can hold a value in a program. A variable is given a user-defined name and is identified with a data type. The data type identifies the type of value the variable can store. Every single variable that you reference in a program should be declared in the declaration section. Here is an example of a PLSQL program where the word hello is displayed on the screen. A declaration section has not been created because there are no values to work with. Contained in the body of the program, which begins with the word begin and ends with the word end, is a single executable statement. In this example, a declaration section has been created. The word declare starts the declaration section. In this program, a variable called ename is declared, which can hold a variable length character data type of value. A value is being assigned to the variable during its declaration. The value is the name Sid. In the body of the program, a display statement displays the word hello, followed by the value contained in the variable ename to display the words hello Sid on the screen. Every variable that you declare must have a data type associated with it that will identify the type of value that the variable can store. The possible data types are number, which can store numeric data, char, which is fixed length character data. If you don't specify a size for a variable defined to be of char type, then the default size of the variable will be a single character. The next data type is varchar2 and represents variable length character data. A variable defined as varchar2 type must have a size. The date data type allows you to store date type of values in a dd-mon-yy format. In PLSQL, you can have a data type called boolean. The values taken by a boolean variable can be true, false, or null. These types of variables are used in conditional statements such as an if statement. When you declare a variable in the declaration section, the name of the variable and its data type are mandatory. The name can be any name of your choice. You can specify one or more spaces followed by the data type and an optional size. The size is mandatory for a varchar2 variable. The slide has a number of examples of variable declarations. The first variable is called bday and will store date type of values. The next variable is vsalary. It can store numeric data with a precision of 10 and a scale of 2. The next variable is vename. It will store character data with a maximum width of 10 characters. The variable called active is of Boolean type and it can store the values true, false, or null. When declaring a variable, each variable declaration should be terminated with a semicolon. Also note that in all these examples, the initial value that is stored for these variables will be null. Here you're looking at initializing a variable during its declaration. Storing a value into a variable is done using the assignment operator, which is a colon followed by the equal sign. When you are initializing a variable with a value during its declaration, you can specify the value after the assignment operator. Date, char, and varchar2 variables should be enclosed in single quotes. In the example, the variable bday is declared to store date values and its initial value is 10th of Feb 1999. The second example stores the value 55 as the initial value for the variable vSalary. In the next example, the value Sid is stored as the initial value of the variable vEname. And in the last one, you have the value false being stored as the initial value of the variable called active. Also note that the value false is not enclosed in single quotes. When you declare a variable, you can optionally use the keyword constant. The word constant identifies that the value assigned to the variable during its declaration cannot be changed in the program. It is used when you want to create a variable to hold a certain value that will not change in the program. For example, if you're creating a variable that can hold the tax rate for a given state, you could declare such a variable as a constant because the tax rate is something that does not change for a state. In the example, the variable bday is declared to be of constant type. Its initial value is 10th of Feb 1999. In the body, you are trying to assign another value 12th of Feb 1999 for the same variable called bday. This will not work. You'll receive an error when you run the program as shown on the slide. When you declare a variable, you can associate it with a not null clause. This would mean that the variable being declared cannot take a null value in the program. In the example, the variable bday is being created to be of date type. It is being identified as not null. An initial value of 10th of Feb 1999 has been assigned to bday. This type of assignment of a variable during its variable declaration for a not null variable is mandatory. In the body of the program, the variable bday is taking two types of values. The first assignment stores the value 12th of Feb 1999. The second assignment, where the variable is taking the value null, will fail because bday has been declared to be of not null type.